Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn about the interior of the heart. So for interior of the heart, we had taken the specimen of heart and then we had take a cut section through the auricle towards the inferior side, and we had just opened up the wall of the right atrium. Now over here you can see we have opened up the interior structures of the right atrium. So now after opening the interior of the right atrium, we can see the structures inside the right atrium. So you can see over here the separations, which is, this is the anterior part of the right atrium and this is the posterior part of the right atrium. So the anterior part and posterior part is subdivided by this ridge, which is known as an crista terminalis. So this crista terminalis, the anterior part, you can see it is a bit roughened due to the presence of musculi pectini. And this is the posterior part. Here we can see a multiple opening. The first opening that we noted over here is this opening, which is the opening of superior vena cava. So this is the opening of superior vena cava. Just onto the inferior aspect, you can see this opening, which is known as the opening of inferior vena cava. So these are the first two opening. Then over here, just besides this opening of the inferior vena cava, you can see there is another opening. This opening is known as a coronary sinus. All the veins of the heart drain into this coronary sinus, and through that it will drain ultimately into the right atrium. So now let's see the further structures. So one of the most important structures that present into the right atrium is this fossa ovalis. You can see over here, this area is known as an fossa ovalis, which is bounded by these boundaries. Okay, so this fossa ovalis is having embryological importance. This fossa ovalis in embryo, it is the opening between the right atrium and left atrium. So that is about the fossa ovalis. So now over here, there is the opening of inferior vena cava. Just inferior to this inferior vena cava and just besides this crista terminalis, there is a place where the SA node is present. SA node is the one which gives the electrical impulses to the heart. So that is about the SA node. So after opening this right atrium, there is another opening that is well markable over here. This is the communication between your right atrium and your right ventricle. This communication is known as a tricuspid valve. You can easily notice that there are three cusps, first one, second one and third one over here. After this, you can see this opening of the right ventricle. Here you can notice this cups is attached with this part, which is known as a cauda tendini. This cauda tendini further attached to this muscle, which is known as a papillary muscle. This papillary muscle is attached to the wall of the right ventricle. So this is the wall of right ventricle. Now there is a three parts of these muscles, which is known as an ridges, bridges and pillars. So this is the example of pillars. Now over here you can see the opening of the pulmonary trunk. Okay, this is the opening of the pulmonary trunk. Even you find the semilunar valve lips over here. So this is the lip of the semilunar valve over here. So just below this semilunar valve, there is a ridge which is known as a supraventricular ridge, which is the example of ridge variety of muscles. And the last one is, you can find over here, which is known as a bridge variety of muscle. This over here, you can find out, this is known as a moderator bend. This moderator band has communication from the wall of the ventricle to the base of this papilla. You can find out this muscle's attachment over here. So this is the three variety of the muscles. Over here, there is a rough area. This rough area is known as a trabeculae carinae. This three variety that we talked about is actually the example of this muscle. Okay, so the trabeculae carinae has a three variety, which is the first one is the pillar one, then the bridges one, and the ridges one. Okay, so that is about the right ventricle. So after understanding the features, now let's see a few clinical anatomy that is related with the tricuspid valve. So you can see over here, this is the opening of tricuspid valve. If this tricuspid valve opening get narrower, then this is known as a tricuspid stenosis, okay, which is a common clinical anatomy of this tricuspid valve. Apart from that, there is another clinical anatomy which is known as an tricuspid regurgitations. In this regurgitations, when this tendon or this chorda tendon become weak, this lip of the valve, okay, it will regurgitate inside this right atrium. So that is known as an tricuspid regurgitation. Thank you.